各位同学好，我是林文老师。你今天所收看的是贾博士传记 Steve Jobs 的 Biography。 今天我们选录的是第17回合，说明这个蓝盒子贩售之后给贾博士后来的概念，他的行销方式一样，听说读写，了解背景再听说读写，效果是最好的。我们先听听看中文的时候你对照英文来吧。
也就是那时候发生了一件具有里程碑意义的事件，也确立了今后他们合作关系的模式。乔布斯认为蓝盒子不该再停留在业余爱好阶段了，他们可以制作然后销售。我把剩下的元件都集中起来，比如说盒子、电源和数字键盘，然后想出了定价方式。乔布斯说，这也预示了他日后在创立苹果公司过程中将扮演的角色。成品的大小差不多有两副扑克牌那么大，所有的零部件价值$40。乔布斯决定以$150的价格出手，追随着诸如咔嚓船长这样的飞客的脚步。两人也给自己起了别名，沃兹尼亚克成了伯克利兰，乔布斯叫做奥拉夫·图巴克。他们会敲响各个宿舍的门，寻找感兴趣的人，然后把蓝盒子连上电话和扬声器进行演示。潜在的买家在一旁看着，他们就会现场演示给诸如伦敦的丽兹酒店这样的地方打电话，或者是拨打澳大利亚的打电话厅消化服务电话。我们做了大概100个蓝盒子，几乎全卖出去了，乔布斯回忆说。
听到之后你会觉得他们实在太厉害了，所以我看到台湾的杂志有讲说，贾博士如果是一个这个外向的人，他就不会有今天的 iPhone。 不，你觉得这他是内向的吗？这个就听起来很好笑，所以用自己的眼睛看，自己的心里去阅读，就发现到网络上很多的事情是骗人的，他们借了贾博士来卖他的书本而已，自己第一手来看资料。接下来我们听听看英文的朗读吧。 Alexa
It was then that they reached an important milestone, one that would establish a pattern in their partnerships. Jobs came up with the idea that the blue box could be more than merely a hobby, they could build and sell them. I got together the rest of the components, like the casing and power supply and keypads, and figured out how we could price it, Jobs said, foreshadowing roles he would play when they founded Apple. The finished product was about the size of 2 decks of playing cards. The parts cost about $40.And Jobs decided they should sell it for $150. Following the lead of other phone freaks such as Captain Crunch, they gave themselves handles. Wozniak became Berkeley Blue, Jobs was Oftobark. They took the device to college dorms and gave demonstrations by attaching it to a phone and speaker. While the potential customers watched, they would call the Ritz in London or a dial-a-joke service in Australia. We made 100 or so blue boxes and sold almost all of them, Jobs recalled.
简单来说，你不觉得他们发明这个东西太厉害了？当然他有点非法，就是他用违法的打电话可以打到伦敦的丽兹酒店，对不对？也可以拨到澳洲去听电话的笑话服务。你不觉得他做了100多个，成本$40，那卖150块钱，就代表奠定了他不断的行销的基础，不断的往外扩展，又加上他的技能，所以真的是一个人聪明的时候是无法阻挡住他发光发热的。那接下来呢，我只讲解一个重要的单字，这个字叫做 attach， 很多同学会把它看成是攻击，只有再说明一点，你背单词背不清楚才会把它看成攻击。这个字明明后面是 H 结尾，叫 attach。 那你们在荧幕上看到它有重点，它可以当动词可以当名词，而且动词其实常用的是被动式。当然你翻字典会得到更多的解释。我们来看 attach 这个单字的发音，有美式跟英式用法。
attach
基本上不难，你看后面介词都用谁， Attached a photo to my application form， 就代表说它贴到上面去。那最来的话，我们来看看它后面的介词的语法。介词这边有没有看到 Attach to a phone speaker， 他把这个蓝盒子这个 blue box 贴到他的手机跟一般，当然它不是手机，是电话了，再加上它的一个扬声器，就所谓的喇叭，叫 speaker。 所以代表说大家看卖了100多个，哎，手边就有钱可以做很多事情了，难怪后来他会去抽一些大麻，后来他再自己再真正把这一把给戒掉。好，那接下来我们最后再听一遍的时候，各位同学记得把自己的耳朵打开来，把很多的重要单词听他发音。虽然你可能不了解什么叫 foreshadow， 你不了解什么叫 component， 什么叫 partnership milestone， 等等的，但是你要先听到它发音啊，后面才会好背的。来吧，准备再一次朗读开始。
It was then that they reached an important milestone, one that would establish a pattern in their partnerships. Jobs came up with the idea that the blue box could be more than merely a hobby, they could build and sell them. I got together the rest of the components, like the casing and power supply and keypads, and figured out how we could price it, Jobs said, foreshadowing roles he would play when they founded Apple. The finished product was about the size of two decks of playing cards.The parts cost about $40, and Jobs decided they should sell it for $150. Following the lead of other phone freaks such as Captain Crunch, they gave themselves handles. Wozniak became Berkeley Blue, Jobs was Ove Tobark. They took the device to college dorms and gave demonstrations by attaching it to a phone and speaker. While the potential customers watched, they would call the Ritz in London or a dial-a-joke service in Australia.We made 100 or so blue boxes and sold almost all of them. Jobs recalled.
Hey Google, define attachment.
This is the definition of attachment. An extra part or extension that is or may be attached to something to perform a particular function.
希望你有听到你耳朵想听到的关键字。当然了，要学更详细的内容，觉得意犹未尽，找林文老师上课。BBC 讲解了两年，经济学人杂志7年的时间，再加上丹布朗的小说以及多益特别有纠正发音服务呢，拜拜。